Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my sisters and brothers. I am so delighted to see you, and most importantly, delighted to welcome the beautiful month of Ramadan. It is here. We are now in Ramadan mode, my sisters and brothers. I hope you are as excited as I am about this blessed month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us to actually have as an additional month in our lives to worship Him, to sacrifice for Him, and to use this as an opportunity to regain our souls through our prayers and our du'as to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for all of our shortcomings, for all of our sins in the previous year, and to actually cleanse our souls and renew us, you know, through this 29, 30 days of fasting, and forgive us and save us from the hellfire. So I am so excited. I can't believe it. As I've said before, you know, this beautiful month, you know, comes once a year and it just sneaks up on us, but in a great and wonderful way that it sneaks up on us. I'm grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving me another month of Ramadan. This is one of my prayers to Him, is to grant me that opportunity. And I hope it is a prayer that you ask of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you in your life. Now we have to prepare. So what are we doing tonight? It's Taraweeh night. Are you ready? If your masjid is permitting Taraweeh, mashallah, may Allah bless you and your masjid community in being able to perform those prayers together. If your masjid, your local masjid, is not permitting you, that doesn't mean you can't pray Taraweeh. You can pray Taraweeh with your family in your own home. You know, being able to do it with your children, your wife, your siblings, is a beautiful thing. And as I said earlier, we have to improvise. We have to improvise with this pandemic and find ways to adapt, you know, our environment to our worship. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful. And He is, you know, welcoming of whatever it is that we need to do in order to not stop our lives and not curtail our worship. So use this time to be with your family, to make your Taraweeh. It's also, you know, hours away, we have to prepare for Suhoor. What are you going to have for Suhoor this first day of Ramadan? So, you know, inshallah, it will be an easy fast for you. You will be able to fast with great ease, and that the month will zip through for you and your family. And I know that many of you might be wondering, maybe it's not the first day, you know, of Ramadan. And alhamdulillah, we are fortunate in this day and age that there are so many ways for us to be able to find out when does the new moon come out. Of course, you know, if you are one of those who needs to see the moon, there are, you know, plenty of places across the country that actually are looking to sight the moon, and they will report to people and let them know at their local masajid. We also are blessed to have organizations, you know, through the, you know, the U.S. Muslim Council, Fiqh Council, where they actually have devised the scientific method, where, you know, people are, you know, aware exactly when the moon comes out. I know that ISNA, the Islamic Society of North America, uses this. You can also go to their website to make sure that, you know, when Ramadan starts. So, you know, follow your heart and make the intention of which way you're going to follow, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from you and grant you the opportunity to kick off this beautiful month with your prayer, with your fasting, with your du'as, with your i'tikaf, inshallah, when it comes to the last 10 days. And most importantly, just, you know, being in community with your family and your larger community during this beautiful, blessed month, and finding ways to sustain your spirituality through lectures on Zoom events that will be held by various scholars is a great way to connect that way. So my brothers and sisters, it's been such a great honor and privilege to do these videos with you on a daily basis and helping you prepare for the month of Ramadan. Thank you for letting me into your home to share with you. May Allah accept our fast and may He grant us the best in all that we ask from Him, and most importantly, to save us from the hellfire and to forgive us for our sins and to grant us Jannah. So thank you, brothers and sisters. Jazakumullah khair for tuning in. And I will see you some other time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.